Welcome to New Beginnings.
Good morning, New Beginnings family. My name is Pastor Neil Platon, and I welcome you to New Beginnings Worship. We are blessed that you're here with us today as we worship God together. As we center our hearts for worship, reflect on these words. The Lord of mercy and abundant love gathers us here this day that we may hear his healing words of compassion and to be transformed by his love, that we may become more faithful servants in our thoughts, words, and deeds. To this end, let us worship God.
Hi, I'm Scott, and I'm the liturgist for this Sunday. Please join for the call to worship. God has given us this day of praise. Praise be to God for this most generous gift. God has given his Son so that we might learn ways of peace and mercy. Let the words of God's own Son, Jesus, enter into our hearts and transform our lives. Come, let us worship this great God of abundant mercy and love. Let our songs, our words, and our thoughts reflect God's healing and restoring love. Amen.
Yeah.
join together. Lord of mercy and abundant love, we have gathered here this day to hear your healing words of compassion and to be transformed by your love. Help us to become more faithful servants in our thoughts, words, and deeds. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. I have decided to follow Jesus. No turning back, no turning back. Though I'm going with me, I still will follow. Though I'm going with me,
let us now prepare our hearts for prayer as we sing Spirit Song. Loving God, thank you for being our shepherd. We thank you for leading us, loving us, even giving up your life so that we might be restored to an intimate, everlasting fellowship with you, our Creator. And because you are our shepherd, our protector, our defender, we desire to share some of our needs with you. Listen to each of our hearts as we silently share our most private and personal needs. O Lord, help us in the growth process of our spirituality. Increase our own appreciation of who you are. Impress us that, like you, we can love those who are very different from ourselves. Make us more sensitive to you and to one another, more conscious, O God. Bring us to both humility and boldness. Shepherd us in our own spiritual journey. Give us the courage to be merciful, the endurance to be faithful to those in our care, and just as you are with each of us. For these things we ask in the name of our Lord and of our Savior Jesus Christ, and who taught us to pray by saying together, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.
Today's reading is from Ruth, chapter 4, verses 13 through 22. The genealogy of David. So Boaz took Ruth, and she became his wife. When they came together, the Lord made her conceive, and she bore a son. Then the woman said to Naomi, Blessed be the Lord who has not left you this day without next to him, and may his name be renowned in Israel. He shall be to you a restorer of life and a nourisher of your old age. For your daughter-in-law, who loves you, who is more to you than seven sons, has borne him. Then Naomi took the child, laid him in her bosom, and became his nurse. The women of the neighborhood gave him a name, saying, A son has been born to Naomi. They named him Obed. He became the father of Jesse, the father of David. Now, these are the descendants of Perez. Perez became the father of Hezron. Hezron of Ram. Ram of Ammadab. Ammadab of Nashon. Nashon of Salmon, Salmon of Boaz, Boaz of Obed, Obed of Jesse, and Jesse of David.
Garden alone, while the dew
Will you bow your hearts with me as you come to God in prayer? May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be made acceptable in thy sight through Jesus Christ our Lord, our Savior, Redeemer, and Friend. Amen. So Boaz took Ruth as his wife. It's interesting to see the blessings of God on Ruth's life as she has come so far, so fast. Only a little while ago, she was called a foreigner in Ruth chapter 2, verse 10. Then she's called a lower class servant in chapter 2, verse 13. And then in chapter 3, verse 9, during her proposal, she's called Matika, which is a class of servant eligible for marriage to an Israelite. Then at last, here in our chapter, chapter 4, verse 13, she's called the wife of Boaz. God grant Ruth's petition back in chapter 3, verse 9, when she asked Boaz to spread your garment over your servant, for you are a redeemer, when she'd proposed marriage to Boaz. Security and reward have been provided for Ruth, just as Naomi had prayed in chapter 1, verse 9. May the Lord grant that you may find a place of rest, each one in the house of her husband. And as she had set out to find in verse 3, when she said, "My daughter, shall I not seek security for you, that it may go well for you?" Boaz also prayed for Ruth in chapter 2, verse 12. "May the Lord reward your work, and may your wages be full from the Lord, the God of Israel, under whose wings you have come to take refuge." Acknowledging that her refuge in the Lord, the God of Israel, and as God has been a refuge for her, just as he is a refuge for us. And more than that, we are told in verse 13 that God enabled Ruth to conceive. Some of the most important work that God does in our lives is the work that he works out behind the scenes, through the circumstances in our lives, unseen much of the time. We see that the Lord does reward hesed, or that caring, compassion, and loving kindness that had characterized Ruth's love toward Naomi, her mother-in-law. And if he will reward caring and compassion and loving kindness in Ruth's life, then how much more in our lives? And here in verse 14, the action shifts away from Boaz and Ruth and back to Naomi. This kind of makes sense, since the book of Ruth started with her, and in many ways has been her story as much as Ruth's. The women of Bethlehem blessing God for how he has provided for Naomi. Naomi's return to Bethlehem, her going directly to the field of Boaz, the only one who would be her kinsman redeemer, her accepted marriage proposal, God's provision of legal victory in the hearing before the elders, and Ruth's conception have all been according to God's plan. And the women bless God for his provision, and may his name become famous in Israel, as the scripture says. The blessing that all the people of Bethlehem back in verse 11 gave to Boaz, that he may achieve wealth in Ephrath and become famous in Bethlehem, is echoed for his son, except that they pray for this little boy's name to be famous not only in Bethlehem, but throughout the entire land of Israel. Their blessing is that this little boy is the one who revives her spirit, cause life to return to her, giving her joy, comfort, and consolation to sustain her in her old age. Notice the reason why they are confident in this blessing. Because of the love that Ruth has shown to Naomi in keeping her promise to always be with her and love and care for her. And as they say, she has been better to Naomi than seven sons. I guess the ideal social security system of the day. And the women tie all of this to Ruth's son, because all the women know that Ruth will teach her son to love and to be kind to Naomi as well. God has made sure that there will always be someone to care for Naomi. And that's what the women are celebrating here, particularly in verse 16. Then Naomi took the child and laid him in her lap and became his nurse. So Naomi, who has longed for children during almost the entire book of Ruth, gets to take this little boy into her lap. Naomi became more like a second mother to this little boy. This little one has already given her a new vocation and new purpose in life to fulfill. And in fact, their relationship was so obvious from the beginning that the neighbor women, as we read in verse 17, says, "And the neighbor women gave him a name, saying, 'A son has been born to Naomi.'" So it was just as if Naomi was this little boy's mother as well. And all that she had prayed for and anguished over has now been fulfilled in this little boy. And the neighbor women shout, "A son has been born to Naomi," which is exactly what they would have said to Ruth, and more specifically, Boaz. When the little baby was first born, they're echoing it here for Naomi as well. So they named him Obed. He is the father of Jesse, the father of David. You know, it is only in the Old Testament example of someone other than the parents naming the child. Now, it could be that everyone was gathered at the house of Naomi for the circumcision and naming of the baby. They named him Obed, which means the one who serves, and of course, just by being born. This baby is playing his part in fulfilling the need for a kinsman redeemer that Naomi had, and the blessing that this little one will take care of Naomi, even in her old age. It's also likely that Obed was a shortened form of Obadiah or Obadiah, which means one who serves Yahweh, or the one who serves God. And this also makes sense in context, because we immediately read that Obed was the father of Jesse, who was the father of King David. So little Obed served God's purpose in bringing forth Israel's king, and of course, ultimately, down through the generations, the King of Kings, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. And so the prayer of the women that Obed would be famous in Israel is fulfilled as well. The guiding hand of God is shown to be mighty as he cares for these two defenseless widows, one of whom is a foreigner who seemingly had nothing to offer anyone at this point, God demonstrates that He can use faithfulness and kindness and love to do amazing things. And in this case, provided the entire nation of Israel with King David and ultimately their Messiah, Jesus. All of this happened because of God's providence, and it demonstrated a pattern through which God would continue to work through this family. One of the purposes of this book is likely to show to everyone that David was God's choice for king of Israel. But David didn't remain king because he was clever and shrewd, or because he played the game of politics. He was there because he was God's man and willing to be used by him. And we can be sure that when we, as his servants, demonstrate the same love for him, and we demonstrate that same hesed, that same loving kindness and compassion for his people that Ruth did and that David did, God will use that faithfulness to do extraordinary things. May it be so as we continue with our life together and with God. Amen. New Beginnings family, we hope that you've been receiving our church updates. Please let us know. Call us at 909-515-5770 or email us at newbeginnings.nbie@gmail.com. We have started our community groups at our campuses. If you would like to be part of any of our community groups, you can contact Gail Apt. Our campuses are now open to groups of 10 people or less. Check out our email blast and website for more information. If you need to be in any of our campuses, you need to email Gail. Her email is at gapt.nbie@gmail.com. Please don't forget, our next in-person service is on September the 5th at our downtown campus. You need to make a reservation with Gail. Please email her at gapt.nbie@gmail.com and see you at the worship service. Our Highland Preschool is still in the process of reopening. We are still waiting for the licensing office to give us the go signal to reopen. In the meantime, you can call our director of preschool, Josie Carino, for registration information. We continue to have our weekly Zoom studies. Don Liefer leads us this Tuesday evening with What's in Your Hymnal, and yours truly on Friday evenings for Bible study. Both studies are at 7 o'clock in the evening. Check out our website or email blast for the link to these studies. Friends, we're still looking for volunteers for online greeters for worship and also for choir members unable to record at home. Please contact Fernando at fernandowestry@gmail.com to schedule a recording on Thursday. Also, we have received copies of the September-October Upper Rooms. And so if you'd like to receive a copy of this devotional, please call the church office and I'll be more than happy to deliver this to you. Don't forget that our Zoom fellowship hour is at noon today. So check out our chat, our email blast, or website for the link to join our online fellowship. We thank you so much for your continuing support to New Beginnings. If you'd like to give financially to the church, you can do so by making your checks payable to New Beginnings United Methodist Church. No abbreviations, please. Or you can go on our website, nbie.org, and by clicking on the Giving tab. You can also give through text. Here is now a short video on how to text to give. Thank you. Again, we thank you all so much for your continuing support and prayers for New Beginnings, and may God continue to bless us all. Friends, our service is now over, but our life with God and with each other continues. Hear now our benediction. As Christ has fed and redeemed your life, now go into the world in peace and love, offering ministries of hope and justice to everyone you meet. Go in peace, my dear friends, and until we meet again, in Christ's name we pray. Amen.